Hey there, everybody, it's AirPirateCid, and welcome back to more Let's Play Parasite Eve! In the last episode, I pretty much was just playing around at the precinct after I saw Daniel Falcon punch a reporter in the back of the head, which was hilarious. Anyways, as a random note, Final Requiem 1983 has pointed out to me that the treasure chests that are where Taurus and Dwayne are, or Wayne, I can't think of his name right now, that had the medicine and the ammo that they will refill. And I did some research on it, and apparently on day 2 you will get an ammo plus 6, on day 3 you will get ammo plus 15, day 4 is also 15, and then day 5 is ammo plus 30. As for the medicine, it goes medicine 1 for day 2, days 3 and 4 it will be in medicine 2, and then after that on day 5 it'll be a medicine 3. Alright, now that we have that out of the way, okay, let's continue on up here, see if I can do anything in here really quick. Come on, there we are. So far I don't think that I can do anything. I have to go report back to, yep, I have to report back to Baker apparently. That's an awkward name to have, I guess. I mean, I don't know. Okay, let's continue on down. Maybe I should not record these Let's Plays whenever I'm, like, extremely sleepy, because it's probably not going to play out well in my favor. Let's talk to you again. Yes, every boy does need a father. Yep, see, Captain Baker was looking for us, but that's kind of sad about, like, how Daniel and Ben's relationship is. I don't know. Okay, now we continue on up here to Baker's office. Okay, yeah, you will not automatically walk us there until we walk, like, halfway there. I mean, come on. It's too easy, game. We're having a press conference. Oh boy, national television. All of a sudden, spur of the moment, right now. Don't let the pressure get to you. Yeah, the media is a real asshole in real life. I mean, the media just takes one thing and then they blow it way out of proportion, and I hate media. I mean, that's mostly why I don't really watch the news half the time, is just because media blows shit way out of proportion, and it's ridiculous. But that's enough of my own personal life right there. Opera Theater Incident Press Conference, Captain Baker. Sorry. Okay, I cannot read the rest of Captain Baker's name. Or Sergeant Baker, I don't know. I'm trying to read the backboard, I've never done that before. So you are saying that this could be the work of terrorists? Yes, terrorism! How about accounts of officers and firemen at the scene bursting into flames? Ah, crap. I freaking skipped it by accident. Then how did Detective Brea survive without so much as a minor burn? I'm asking her the question. Ah, well, way to be a jerk about it, reporter. You have to say her in all caps. You know what? I blame Dinkelberg for all of this. It's all Dinkelberg's fault. I don't care whoever says whatever. It's all Dinkelberg. It's not Eve. Dinkelberg. Melissa did die. Her body had been taken over by the Eve. Yes, it's an alien, of course. We should get the Men in Black on this, man. I mean, that'd be pretty funny. Yep, that's the end of this. Way to go, Aya. You screwed up. You weren't supposed to talk. But no, you had to anyways. See, look, even Baker's pissed at you. Ah, you're too attractive to stay mad at. I'm sorry. Okay, but he's apparently not taking that. Saved by the phone. Who? What? When? How? What position? Wait, what? I don't know. Put him through then. Ha! I said what position and it said what put him through then. Disturbing. Alright, there we go. Some Japanese scientist, I think, couldn't understand his English too well. He was raving about some mito-something. It's mitochondria. See? Yeah, I actually learned about mitochondria in high school, but it's actually through this video game that I understood a lot about it, and I have a funny story to tell. Whenever I was in high school and I was like in life science and we were just like studying about cells, we had to end up writing a report about like particular cell parts, and I managed to choose the mitochondria. And I had been playing through this game a couple of times, so I had decided to already do mitochondria really for that reason, and this game had partially helped me out on that. And also, well, I did some research on it online, and it was pretty funny how I actually ended up doing that. Okay, let's talk to you. Yes, we have to meet him out front, but before we do, you go down here and go right here. There's a save point. Yes, I would love nothing more than to save my progress. Alright, there we go. Slot 2. Yes, I do. Alright. Now that that's out of the way, my game kind of keeps lagging, which makes it rather difficult to move around. It's like lagging in spikes, man. I mean, it's going to come out perfectly fine whenever I release this video, but whenever I'm playing it, it's kind of getting annoying. I don't like how it lags in spikes. It sucks. Alright, let's go out here. And now we are out of here. Okay, now it's time to go to the museum. There we go. Yes, the Museum of Natural History. Mitochondria something, okay. Yes, you will have a grand time with this one, actually. Or at least I personally think you will. And whoa, holy crap, the frame rate is dropping like crap. I gotta pause it and I'll be back, people. Alright, sorry about that. I don't know what just happened with my game and... or my computer just decided to drop like a crap ton of freaking frames, so I don't know how that's gonna play out. Anyways, back on to the story. Oh, you just got burned. I just got a disturbing mental image in there. Yeah, basically stuff happened, Naya. Life happened. He became his boss, and your boss as well. Alright, let's go to the American Museum of Natural History. I have a special Easter egg to show you all later. Just because I'm kind of too lazy to show it right now. I have never... Well, actually, no, I take that back. The last time I've actually been to a museum was back... I forget. I know it's been a couple of years. I think it's been like 2 or 3 years since I've been to a museum. Let's go up here and talk to security guard right here. Holy crap, it's Larry from Night at the Museum. Only he got old. It's like future Larry, the night guard. Alright, good. We get to go inside the building. Whee! Are things alive in this building yet? No, because it's daytime, people. Alright, research lab on the second floor. Alright. We got this. Yay, we gotta go up the stairs. Woo, let's go upstairs right now. Oh, no. Gee, Daniel, you sucker punch a guy in the back of the head. Why don't you just get your ass down here and sign in your own name? Fine. We have to... Okay, come on, game, quit lagging. Whoa-ho-ho-ho, I think Larry just hit on you there, Aya. Okay, now we go up this staircase. Whee! Okay, we get to go follow Daniel here. Oh yeah, the door's open, so the only natural logic is to go check it out, I guess. I mean, why not? Okay, every single time I hear, like, Clamp typing on his computer, it's set in a particular tone, and it's just really catchy. I like it. He's ignoring you. Because he's, like, all too into his little typing tune. Oh, shiz. What's he doing? Wait a second. Aya's having more repressed memories! Uh-oh. She thinks she knows him. What a pure and utter coincidence! No, she just had a, you know, she just had a flashback. That suspect ignited people. They set them ablaze. They killed them with fire. It's all Dinkelberg's fault. Oh lordy, he's about to go into his, like, long mitochondria speech. The mitochondria possesses its own unique genetic code. Precisely. Parasite? That's an interesting way of describing this most fascinating creature. We cannot live without the mitochondria, do you understand? The mitochondria creates energy for us. Without it, we're nothing! We are here because the mitochondria allows us to be here. Our brain, for example. The brain functions due to an interaction between axons and dendrites. This interaction is possible due to the energy of the mitochondria provides. Did you know that the mitochondria is capable of discharging 200,000 volts of electricity? This not only pertains to electrical discharge, but also applies to heat energy as well. Yes, the combustions last night were from the mitochondria. For a human to burn and melt, 1600 degrees of heat must be generated. There are several hundred mitochondria present within a single cell. If all of the mitochondria in the body began functioning at the same time, a tremendous amount of energy would be generated and released. Melting a human into a puddle of fluid would be a simple task with so much energy. Oh man. You have no idea. Yeah, I'm gonna have to stop the video right here because I think I'm out of time right now. So, thank you all for watching Let's Play Parasite E Part 5. In the next episode, I plan on finally getting into some action. So, I will see you all there.